lot of things are coming together that will change the way that we live. There's no need for fear. It is here. We need to adapt. We need to embrace it. Well, like any of the previous industrial revolutions, it's clear that the fourth industrial revolution is driven by technology, but it's not technology alone. It will change how people live, how we interact, how we do business, and how government functions. But it's clear that it's driven by innovation, by artificial intelligence, by robotics, but also by biotechnologies. But it will also help us to see how we can be more connected across the globe, across the world. It will also shape how we look at the world. So in that respect, it will touch a lot of different aspects of our lives. Well, business will have to evolve. They will have to continue to invest and to improve their own companies. They will have to move up in the value chain. They will have to invest in innovation, making sure the technology becomes an integral part of their doing business in the world. So it will shape their vision on the world and making sure that also there, a lot of investment is needed. We need to invest in, for example, the Internet of Things, making sure that in industry, things are better monitored, that data is being better used in order to optimize business processes. We see that a lot of top jobs are being touched upon. 60%, two-thirds of people will have to be retrained, reshaped, and have a new function in the next 10 or 15 years. So I think that the fourth industrial revolution will be really an opportunity for job creation and growth. It will help us to shape new jobs. So it's important that we invest in education from an early age. We have to bring people, young girls, young boys, in contact with technology to let them understand in what kind of world they will live tomorrow. Adaptability will be a really important aspect of it. I'm a biologist myself, and people have to adapt. And so that's one of the key messages I want to give, that adaptation, adaptability, being able to be retrained, to stay curious also with what is going on in the outside world will be key to success. And really built upon a continuous education during the whole lifetime of people. But there's also a need for creativity, the human touch, making sure that people know how to interact, how they can embrace these new technologies to improve their own lives and to improve the lives of others. And so in that respect, the human touch is really important. And so we need to also invest in that. We have to invest in the hard skills, but also in the soft skills, making sure that people understand what these new technologies are doing and how they're changing their lives. But on the other hand, also making sure that communication and an open mind, tolerance towards others, is also key to the fourth industrial revolution. We have to embrace it, we cannot fight it. It is here today. Politics will play an important role. On the one hand, government needs to invest in education, in infrastructure, but it also has to push the public debate, be much more open to the world, be much more open and connected to its citizens, making sure that people trust these new technologies, really making sure there's a framework that, for example, privacy is respected, because in the end, it will be about trust when data is being used. For me, the fourth industrial revolution is really a story about new opportunities. It's about new opportunities, increasing the quality of life, making our lives easier. It will change the labor market, it will change the way that we think and behave, and will improve our lives tremendously.